This topic concerns knowing the value of an SI prefix as a power of 10. So what we are given here is a table, and we are told to complete each row of the table below by filling in the missing prefix or missing exponent. So ALEKS provides this table here. You can also reference this metric system prefix figure or table in your lecture PowerPoint as well. So let's look at row 1. 1 milligram is equal to how many grams? Well, that is very easy for us to figure out if we've dedicated ourselves to memorizing the meanings of these various metric prefixes. Let's find milli. Here it is right here. Milli is abbreviated with a lowercase m. That's what we see here. Gram is the SI base unit here that we are measuring, so milligrams. So we're obviously measuring mass. And the meaning of the prefix milli is 10 to the minus 3. Let's investigate what that means. We have 10 to the minus, to a power of the minus 3. Well, I can write this as a fraction. And writing it as a fraction, it looks like this. 1 over 10 to the 3. Well, what is 10 to the third power? It would be equal to 1 over 10 times 10 times 10. What is 10 times 10 times 10 equal to? 1,000. So 10 to the minus 3 is 1 divided by 1,000, or as a decimal, 0.001. So what this is telling me, the meaning of milli is that a milligram is 1/1,000th the mass of a gram, or 1,000 times smaller in comparison to the SI simple unit of a gram. So all of these prefixes are in comparison to the SI units, the simple SI units that we just used in the previous topic. Those units were grams, liters, we had seconds as well, in addition to meters. So again, we have determined, because of the meaning of milli, that 1 milligram is 1,000 times smaller than a gram. And we determine that from the meaning of the prefix. And so when we are completing these tables, the cool thing about this is if we've memorized the meaning of the prefixes, then we can solve the problem like this. If we put a 1 in front of the prefixed unit, this is my prefix unit because this is the prefix, milli. Grams does not have a prefix in front of it. 1 milligram is going to be equal to, well, the number of grams that 1 milligram is equal to will be the exact meaning of the prefix milli. Milli, again, means 10 to the minus 3. So it'll be 10 to the minus 3. Let's do the same thing for the next one. Row 2. We have 1-something grams is equal to 10 to the minus 1 grams. Well, which prefix has the meaning 10 to the minus 1? That would be deci. And so what we do is place the symbol for deci there as the prefix. So once again, we have our prefix unit with the 1 in front. 1 decigram is equal to the meaning of deci, grams. Let's look at the third row. 1 nanogram is equal to how many grams? What is the meaning of nano? The meaning of nano is 10 to the minus 9. If we do the math the same way we did here, that would mean that a nanogram is 1 billion times smaller than a gram. So how many grams is 1 nanogram? The meaning of nano, which is 10 to the minus 9. 1 blank grams is equal to 10 to the minus 2 grams. Which prefix has this meaning? If we check our table, that would be centi. So we take the symbol for centi, lowercase c, and place it there. 1 centigram is equal to 10 to the minus 2 grams. This tells us that a centigram, if we take its meaning, 10 to the minus 2, is 100 times smaller than a gram. Now, in all of these examples, we only used grams as our unit, as our basic SI unit, but we can also use other SI units as well. We could use liters, so we could have milliliters here, nanoliters, deciliters, centiliters. We could also use meters, millimeters, decimeters, nanometers, centimeters. All of those should sound very familiar. It doesn't matter the base SI unit we use, as long as we understand the meanings of the prefixes. Remember, the meanings of the prefixes are all in relation to the base SI unit that you are using. So let's recap that one more time. Kilo, 10 to the minus 3. Let's pick a random base SI unit. Let's use meters. A kilometer or kilometer is 10 to the 3 times, and because the power is positive, it would be larger. It's 10 to the 3 times larger than the base unit, the meter. What is 10 to the 3? 1,000. So a kilometer is 1,000 times larger than a meter. Mega. A megameter is 1,000,000 times larger than a meter. All of these meanings are compared to our base unit. A micrometer is 1,000,000 times smaller than a meter, the base unit. Why smaller? Because the power is negative.